Hey guys, so what you saw today is how we train. We do this day in and day out. We've been doing it this way for 20 years plus. You know, some of these Insta-famous people, man, you know, you see them on the gram, you know, they do one hard crazy set or something. Half time it's something that makes no sense, but it looks, it's cool to watch, but you know, they do it and that's that. This is how we train. We go balls to the wall all out every day, every time we go to the gym. And that's just what we've been doing since me and Johnnie been training together. You know, and we both trained hard before we got, even as an amateur, before we started training together, we both trained balls to the wall. That's how we do it, you know? And I think with today's generation, I think people have gotten a little softer, man. There's very few, I'm not gonna say nobody, there are still a few young guys out there that wanna bust ass and go heavy and give 100% and try to do better than they did last time they were in the gym every single time. But those guys are few and far between. For the most part, these guys have gotten soft, man. Guys don't train like that with the high intensity, and almost nobody trains super heavy anymore. That's how we learned. It's what we do. And you look at all the great champions of the past, they all trained with high intensity and they trained heavy. You know, the Ronnies, the Jays, the Dorians, the Lee Haneys, you know, people like this, they train hard, they train heavy, and their physiques spoke for themselves. So always all these people online and they want to criticize you, oh, you shouldn't go so heavy, blah, blah, blah. Man, you know what I say to that? Fuck you. What have you won?
Yeah, right. Get him. Yep. Yep. Come on.
The difference, I think, from today, from yesterday, when we were coming up, is that, you know, our goal wasn't just to turn pro, you know, or just to make money, you know, or just to live the lifestyle of a pro bodybuilder. You know, our goal was to be the best at what we were doing, you know, at the time, no matter what it was, you know, and so it happened to be bodybuilding. When we're in the gym, so happiness to be, it is training, you know, so it was be number one in the gym, no matter if it's the gym we're training in or the gym across the country or gym, you know, internationally, you want to be better than everyone that's working out at that time. We're working out in whatever gym they're at. So if they could, you know, if they had Instagram Live or Facebook Live back then when we were coming up and training, you know, at our best, then, you know, they can, you know, take a sneak peek at, you know, each, you know, say they place a camera in each gym all around the world and they can take a sneak peek at each, you know, each athlete's, you know, training. And each time you would look, you would definitely say our intensity is the highest. We're training the hardest. We're training the heaviest, you know, without a doubt. Most people goals are, I want to make this money. You know, if I get on stage and I win a couple shows, I can win some extra money, this, that, and the other, you know, or, you know, I'll get recognition from people, you know, you look what I've done, look at me, or whatever like this, you know, that's what's going on today, you know, in bodybuilding, and then you're training in the gym. It's not, you know, focus on your workout, focus on bringing up body parts, focus on your weaknesses, making them your strength, and making sure your strength's getting even better. You know, it was more of, look at me, look what I'm doing, look what I'm doing today. Look, I got to lift that after I waited 10 minutes in between sets.
We've all seen the videos of me with Johnny over the years training, you know, especially when we were competing, getting ready for shows. You know, to train like that, you gotta be motivated, super motivated. You know, for me, my motivation, speaking for myself, came because I wanted to win. You know, I wanted to win whatever contest it was I was preparing for. You know, I wanted to win with the ultimate goal of winning the Mr. Olympia. And if you're trying to be the best in the world at something, if you're not super motivated and you don't live, breathe, and sleep about it all day, every day, you ain't gonna be the best in the world at whatever it is you're trying to do.
Ain't no fucking easy way. That's the fuck. Who it gonna be? Who the fuck it gonna be? Everything you got, baby.
Every single time I came to the gym, I tried to do better than the previous time I was in the gym. I tried to outwork myself. I tried to do more reps, more weight, and train harder every single time. And if you can do that consistently, year after year, day after day, month after month, you'll get better and you will win.
So as you see, you know, on our Tuesday leg workout, you can see the intensity, you can see the grind, you can see the struggle, you know, on our faces and our body. You know, and that's what it takes, challenge. You know, each set, you know, we'll have a warm-up set, of course, before we start, you know, the main sets of the exercise. But after that, you know, you got to challenge yourself each and every time you step up to the plate. You know, first of all, you're concentrating on catching your breath. You know, I can never catch my breath before it's time to do another set. So it's kind of like, you know, get done, settle down, try to catch your breath, you know, get some oxygen so you maximize, you know, your recovery time and maximizing the strength that you have for that next set. and then, yeah, you're shaking in your boots. And like I said, you're out of breath and your mind is going like, oh my God, this is so heavy, but it feels so good. Because you accomplish each set, you accomplish, we're going up in weight. So, you know, each set you accomplish is just, you know, another notch on the belt to make you feel good, like I got through it. But, you know, and feeling good, you're still like, oh my God, it's just so much pressure, it's so heavy. So it's so many multiple things going through your head. It's just, you know, trying to quiet it all down and just focus on what you're doing and concentrate on what you're doing so your form is, you know, as correct as you can be for what the weight you're doing, and you get the right amount of reps in. So yeah, there's a bunch of noise, man. There's, I mean, your body screaming, your head is yelling, you know, you're out of breath and trying to catch that. And meanwhile, you're trying to, you know, stay in there and yell and help the guy out who's training as well. So there are so many factors going in. I can't really, you know, put it in a nutshell, you know, the excitement, the fear, you know, the want to run out of the gym, you know, all that, you know, your escape route, you know, you're looking, all that's going on in your head at one time. It's pretty amazing, but it's so much fun.
We're at the end of the yep. I've been very well worried about medication.
And even crazy yourself, your profile yep. also includes connection to your mind.
Everyone
come on. How you know that
most.
You know, toughness, when you talk about somebody being tough, when I talk about somebody being tough, it's not physical, it's mental. Because toughness comes from within. It's that mental toughness. If you're tough inside and you're tough mentally, your body will get tough. Your body will do what your mind tells it to do. And I think toughness has something to do with being motivated. If you want something really bad, you know, when we're in here training, especially when I was training, still competing, I wanted to win so bad, I didn't care how bad it hurt. I would push through pain. I didn't care. It felt like the muscle was ready to rip off the bone. Sometimes it hurt so bad, but I would not quit. I set the bar so impossibly high that I knew to get there, I was going to have to go through more pain than I'd ever went through to get there, but I was willing to pay the price. And that's just mental toughness. You know, you have to, if you're mentally tough, you can overcome the physical pain, you know, to reach whatever goal it is you set for yourself.
And no weight.
You know, speaking of the mental toughness, I beat a lot of guys I should have never beaten when I was competing. For a simple reason, I was hungrier than they were. I wanted it more than they would. I was willing to do what they wouldn't do. You know, I was willing to do in the gym what they wouldn't do, even though they were probably genetically more blessed than I was, you know, structurally or aesthetically. But because I was willing to pay the price and pay a higher price than they were, I was able to beat them on stage. And that's what it comes down to. Just because you're not the most gifted person in the race doesn't mean you can't win the race. If you want it more than they want it, and you're willing to pay the price, and you're willing to pay a higher price than they are, then you can win. And you can beat a lot of people that are more gifted than you just by outworking them. That's pretty much been the whole story of my career. I see at the press conference, and I see a lot of times when you interview guys at the gym, and all of a sudden they say, oh man, I'm just happy to be here. Man, fuck that shit. I'm here to win. You know, when I was competing, I was fighting number one to win, number two to be the best in the world, number three to support my family. I had a wife, a daughter, a mother I had to take care of. So losing was not an option. I didn't have no safety net. I didn't have no rich parents or no rich grandfather or nothing to fall back on. All that, the weight of all those, my family was on my shoulders. I was there to win. So fuck being there, just being happy to be there. I was there to win, make a paycheck, make a living, and to take care of my family. And most importantly, I wanted to be the champion of the world. And if you don't have that mindset, you're gonna get beat. You ain't gonna be the champion. You know, I wanted to establish a legacy, which I think I did, and I'm still working hard. That's why I'm still in the gym. I train here because I love doing it. And because I'm still upholding the legacy of being a top pro bodybuilder in the world. And you know, so if you're just happy to be there, man, good for you, but I beat all those guys who were just happy to be there. You know, everything I have in life is because of bodybuilding. You know, bodybuilding taught me the hard work, the discipline, the sacrifice to be successful in bodybuilding. I took those principles that I learned and values that I learned from bodybuilding, and I've applied that into business now. And, you know, you take hard work, sacrifice, dedication, persistence, and you take that and apply those principles into business, you'll be successful in business also. And that's what I've done. And it's all because of bodybuilding. It's taught me that. You know, when I started bodybuilding, I had nothing. You know, I lived in a one-bedroom apartment. I had a milk crate for and some pool furniture I took from the pool to have stuff to sit on. And that's all I had, man. So, you know, losing was not an option. I had to win. I was fighting to survive. I was fighting to pay my bills every month, you know. And fortunately, through hard work and discipline and a lot of sacrifice, I was able to move up and have a very good life. And my family has a very good life, and I'm very blessed to have that. But that shit don't happen by chance, man. You know, nobody owes you a damn thing in life. But fortunately, we all live in a place where if you work hard enough, you can do anything you want to do. And I put the work in, and I reap the rewards.
How we doing?
In the States and you're a bodybuilder, and when I say bodybuilder, that applies to all the divisions, whether you're a bikini athlete, physique, classic body, whatever, we're all bodybuilders. It's just different levels of you know, size and mass and all that. You live in this country, there are so many opportunities available, you know, especially if you're a fitness athlete, bodybuilder, there's more opportunities here than anywhere else in the world. And I don't understand these lazy bums that they want everything handed to them. They think, oh, I won whatever show, pay me $100,000 a year. Man, you ain't done nothing. You know, this is the one place in the world you can do anything you want to do and achieve anything you want to achieve. The sky's the limit. But you don't want to put the work in. You know, if these lazy ass, this young generation, not all of them, but more so than any generation I've seen previous, they think they got this entitlement attitude. You know, that they think somebody owes you something. Let me tell you something. Ain't nobody owes you shit, bro. Okay, nobody. If you want something, go out and get it. If you're willing to put the work in and outwork everybody around you, you might get what you want, but if you don't put the work in, you ain't gonna get nothing, man. And don't get pissed off because I made it, because you're a lazy bum, because I put the work in for 27 years and got where I'm at, and you ain't dead shit, and you think you're entitled to have the same life I have? Nah, man, don't work like that. So man the fuck up, go out and put the work in, and then maybe, just maybe, you can get what you want.